Hi, good afternoon, everyone. So welcome to Bifrost 101. I want to deploy. So my name is Mellado, and this is my colleague, Dmitry. We are both principal software engineers at Red Hat. You may recall me from, well, I'm not Troy McClure, but I used to be the Kubernetes PTL before. It's been a long time since I've been on a face-to-face Open Slack Summit, so I'm really glad to be here back in Berlin. Basically, I wanted to tell you a little bit to you about what is Bifrost, what is Ironic, and how are we using those to deploy a lab. And well, I'll be basically letting Dmitry go ahead for, you know, the Ironic and Bifrost power interactions. I got a demo, how it works, and I hope you will be able to learn something and be able to contribute back. So, thank you, Dmitry.
Thank you. Okay. Let's start with a short introduction to Ironic. I actually hope that many of you already know what it is, but anyway, hurts repeating. So Ironic is a bare metal provisioning service under the OpenStack umbrella. Ironic can be used as a Vert backend for Nova, providing you the same API for virtual machines and for bare metal for bare metal machines. There is a project to use Ironic inside Kubernetes. It's called MetalCubed. We did a presentation earlier today about that. And it can be a standalone, for example, with Bifrost. Ironic is a major project, more than 8 years in production. Public clouds, research institutions, small labs, and many other folks use Ironic. There were awesome talks from CERN about how they use Ironic. Unfortunately, it was already in the past, but check out the recordings. Just to be on the same level, I'll repeat some concepts from Ironic so that you understand what we are talking about later on. So a node is a representation of a physical machine. So use Ironic API, create nodes, and run actions on nodes that correspond to action on physical machines. Ports are network interfaces. Port groups are representation of bonding. And we also mentioned a thing called config drive, which is a Nova concept. It's essentially a way to provide information to your instance. In our case, we are writing them to separate partitions on the machine. Ironic consists of many components. The critical ones are its RESTful API in OpenStack Spirit. We have conductor instances which handle nodes, and we have an in-RAM disk agent which you start on nodes to do actions. It's called Ironic Python Agent because it's for Ironic and written in Python. You also have a lot of extra components, such as Ironic Inspector, which is a hardware introspection service. Everything Ironic is doing through drivers. There are a whole family of different drivers, which are actually designed as hardware types and hardware interfaces. I won't go into details about that. You can find a lot of information on the network already. We separate a huge variety of technologies, standard generic technologies like APMI, old school hardware management. Redfish is the next big thing, HTTP, JSON, everything you like. We have limited support for SNMP for power actions. And we have quite a bit of vendor drivers, just to name a few, Dell HP, Fujitsu, Huawei, Lenovo. Have specific drivers in Ironic for more actions that the standard ones are providing. And we have a thing called Ironic Staging Drivers, which is a repository for unsupported drivers. And Bifrost actually supports installing that too. Let's talk about standalone Ironic a bit. Ironic can be used with no or some OpenStack services. You can, for example, plug in and out Neutron, Glance, Cinder, Swift, Nova, or it can be plugin for Nova, it can talk back to Nova. And we have, over the time, developed some specific features for standalone case. These include HTTP basic authentication, and it includes support for using static or external DHCP. Includes support for images, not from Glance, but from HTTP, HTTPS, and file locations, and some other. And with this short introduction, I'm going to talk about Bifrost. And Bifrost, the name coming obviously from the Norse mythology, although I know we pronounce it in the wrong way. I think it's actually Bifrost. But, who knows? So Bifrost is a set of Ansible playbooks to first install Ironic itself and optionally some additional components like Ironic Inspector, Keystone, staging drivers. It's fully powered by Ansible, and also a set of playbooks to use Ironic. So it's all in one. You install, you use, you'll see how easy it is when Daniel shows the demo. Since recently, we also have a small CLI that makes it easier to use Ansible playbooks in the most common cases. So we prepared some good defaults for you if you don't want to figure out all the hundreds of options we have. Operating system support currently includes Stream 9. We just deprecated Stream 8 because of Python 3.6, which OpenStack no longer supports. So if you use Bifrost, if you need Stream 8, use Bifrost Yoga. Ubuntu LTS, currently Focal, we are working on the next one, which is, I forgot the name, and Debian Stable, whatever the latest stable is. The idea is that you literally run a playbook and you start from zero to a data center with ideally one playbook. A bit technical details on how it's done, especially compared to normal OpenStack installation. We use a combined API plus conductor process. So in OpenStack, you usually separate, you know, API surface from like workers, conductors, engines. We don't do it here, just one Ironic. No RabbitMQ. I know we already figured out on the MetalCube talk that people don't like RabbitMQ, so no RabbitMQ, we use JSON RPC. In case of Bifrost, we use Nginx for several tasks for IPX itself. The IPX is UTP-based thing. VirtualMedia, which is next big thing with Redfish. We serve instance images with the same Nginx and we use it for TLS termination. Then we have DNS mask, which we also use for two purposes, for DHCP and for TFTP. And we don't use it for DNS, so just a bit, that's a bit ironic, isn't it? We use static DHCP, and we rely on being able to use BMC to set boot device to local disk so that it doesn't boot into the RAM disk again. As I said, we support some additional services. Ironic Inspector is a part of Ironic ecosystem. Obviously, we support that. But we also support Keystone, just in case you want a bit more than HTTP basic authentication or you want to use a service catalog. We support Ironic Prometheus exporter. We don't support installing Prometheus itself, but we support the exporter that can provide you with metrics from the BMC of your hardware to your Prometheus. And on top of what Ironic can do naturally through its API, we have playbooks that do some additional features. We integrate with Disk Image Builder for building your instance images. So you can provide some parameters to Ansible and the image will be built for you. That applies to both IPA image and instance images. Of course, if you don't want to build your IPA image, we publish ones on Tarbox, OpenStack.org, and Bifrost can use that. We automate config drive building. You can detect your local SSH public key and embed it automatically. You can provide also static networking parameters, and Bifrost will catch them and will use them. It will be done through inventory. Then it will show you the inventory. And the most exotic feature, we can also do optional DHCP allocations in DNS mask. So when you have your inventory, you have MAC addresses, and you have desired IP addresses, we can also configure DNS mask. For these MAC addresses, you'll get these IP addresses. Sad things. IPv6 support is absent. Contributions very welcome. It should be easy. IPv6 works with Ironic. We just need to do something about Bifrost because there's a lot of IPv4 hardcoded everywhere. We're kind of multi-node ready, but there's no playbooks to install Bifrost on several nodes. Nodes here, I mean nodes on which Bifrost is installed, not Ironic nodes. Sorry for confusion. So Bifrost is a single controller thing. And we would love to have optional support from OpenStack projects, or maybe non-OpenStack projects too, for example, Neutron, but we don't have that. So it's on Ironic installed so far. If you want to contribute, come to us. And on this positive note, I'll pass the mic to Daniel.
Thanks a lot, Dmitry. So I want to give you a little bit of context. Basically, I'm a networking guy, or most of my background is on networking, so why the hell did I start with Ironic? And Bifrost, well, mainly because I'm lazy. So I was working with some people from some lab, and they told me, you know, you got your servers, you want to deploy those. So there you go, go load your virtual BMC on every of those. So, well, I tried to do so. It failed miserably because, you know, there's a lot of options, the UFI, BIOS. No, you gotta go back again, and you gotta go change that specific setting. So at some point, I just gave up, and I decided to give it a try, you know, to Ironic, which I've done for OpenStack for a long time. But again, I'm lazy, so I really don't want to install a full-fledged OpenStack. I don't want to install a full-fledged Ironic. I don't want to have the API running or whatever. So I just decided to create some kind of busting node would allow you to do, as I'm going to show you. So Bifrost, as Dmitry was saying before, you have you could do these things in two ways. I'm going to be showing you both. So the first thing you could do, you are lazy. You may even be more lazy than me. So just use Bifrost CLI. So you don't have to know anything. You just have to go, basically, launch that command, and it's going to be doing most of the things for you. A caveat again. So when I first started this, I thought this was working on CentOS Stream 8. And then I found that pip didn't install my libraries, and I found myself into a living hell of debugging pip and what was going on. Again, that was because of Python 3.6 support. It was deprecated. So don't, save yourself with the hell and just go CentOS Stream 9 Plus. Fedora should work too, but it's not really supported, if I recall correctly. Just Python 3.6 Plus, let's say. Regarding the drivers, this is going to be using IPMI and Redfish as the default ones. If you want to install some more fancy stuff, such as Nidrack, you could do so, but it would require some minimal intervention, let's say. So what does this Bifrost CLI command do? So install Python binaries, Ansible collections. In case you don't know what an Ansible collection is, it's basically a set of roles all set together. One of the things that we could improve at some point in Bifrost is to allow the usage of Ansible execution environments, which would probably simplify much more all the dependencies things. Basically, it's a containerized system with all the dependencies built in directly, so you would be able to trigger that from whatever Putman or Docker, whatever you want to do. So again, let's say you just want to go and test Bifrost CLI, but you don't even have a bare metal server. You don't need those. You could just ask, a tool called Sushi Tools, which would basically go and run a virtual VMC for you, and you can just run Bifrost CLI in a way such that it would create just two test nodes for you. You just need a couple of RAM. I mean, this is not Kubernetes, so not 100 plus RAM. So yes, I guess you'd be fine having a laptop with maybe 8 gigs of RAM, which I guess is the industry standard. So I really hopefully that any contributor will be able to have at least 8 gigs of RAM in the laptop. So, recapping. How would you, a new car, I don't know nothing, I just want to run Bifrost, I want to test it because I think it's cool, and I want to test Ironic on my system. So how would you do this? You just have to know a little bit of Git, just clone the repo. I'm maybe assuming that everybody here knows what export OS cloud means, but it might not be the case. Basically, it means that you are using OpenStack client in this case, so it should have a file that would be basically done for you later on, which is called cloud.yaml, and it would have a YAML file basically containing the configuration for your cloud. No OpenStack harm here, but you still need to do this. And you also are supposed to, once you do this, it would just go, you need to source the virtual environment, assuming you'd like to one of those. Okay, there we go. So Bifrost CLI install, and then here we are going over the complex route. I'm going to be showing you a simple one in the demo, assuming it works. But you can specify the network interface and the DHCP pool that you are going to be using for DNS mask. So in the end, let's assume you want to do something a little bit more fancy. In the end, this is all Ansible, JSON, inventories. So you may have just one of those JSON files that you can modify then in any way you code. So you just got to pass those to Bifrost. You could choose the driver. In this case, I'm showing here IPMI, but you could use Redfish, iDrag, or I don't know if there's any more fancy drivers. Probably there are, but anyway. So you could even use RAID if you want to, or do whatever you want, depending on the driver you are using. So, but this basically, this works in two and a half steps, because once you got all this, basically you need to enroll your nodes. That means that you are giving access to Bifrost for them to control those, and then deploy them. If something goes terribly wrong, you could either unenroll them. There's some caveat about that's maintenance mode, whatever, which I think it could be more simplified, but maybe you won't even need those because you may be able to just redeploy. So that's the first one, enroll. Then we'll just go, don't mind the parameters for JSON, to pass it to the Ansible playbook, because you don't really need those. But at some point, it'll be passed into deploying a state. Then basically, you'll have to wait a little bit, so they finish and call back. And when they do what they call back, you can just go and see them as active. By the way, there's also a parameter that you could pass to Bifrost CLI, which is --, wait, if I recall correctly. And it'll just wait for them to be completely deployed. So that said, yeah, that might not be enough for you because, you know, but I run my own playbooks and I want to customize my environment. I just don't want to, you know, deploy a system. I want to do things with them. So again, here comes Ansible. So this installs Ansible for you, so you don't need to do anything fancy. It also goes and use Ansible Galaxy to install every needed collections for you to use. And it'll be configuring Ansible for you. So don't think about Ansible base, Ansible whatever. You know, it's all done for you, so you don't mind. But the power of this is that you, if you already got a couple of playbooks that you got for your own usage on the system, you could just reuse them, make your own Ansible collections, and just go and deploy. And that's, trust me, that's so much, much, much easier. Again, I'm lazy and time effective for you just to deploy your servers on. How would I be able to, you know, run these things again? If you see, this is pretty much the same as we were commenting before, like with you know, Bifrost CLI, but just running Ansible playbook directly. So first, you export the file where you are storing your configuration in the JSON file. Then just run and roll, deploy, and as I said before, if something really goes wrong, you want to debug, or maybe you just don't want to debug, you want to try, you just go and see relaunch, redeploy dynamic YAML. So okay, let's do a simple demo because I talked a lot, but I think it is worth, you know, showing something. Otherwise, you may think that I'm, you know, basically fooling you. So let's see. Let me know if the font is big enough for you. Okay, let's see. I'm gonna be starting just by here. So I just need this is CentOS stream 9. Again, don't use 8. It's not supported. And it will fail miserably, and you'll be, you know, terribly frustrated. Don't. So this is super fast. Thank you, the folks for the network here. I like the KubeCon. So we are basically going to enable Apple and Apple Next repos here. Let's check that they are installed. Okay, they are. Now we're gonna basically clone Bifrost. Go over there. And okay, so again, we are using to go Bifrost CLI to create a minimal setup for us to test. Let's say you want to join us, you want to be a developer, you could just use to, you know, create a quick setup, test setup for you to be the other developer. It'll trigger two VMs using sushi tools, it'll install those, and later on we'll be installing like Bifrost and Neuronic itself. So you would have, you know, the API and the other component running. Okay, so this is now installed. Let's install the test temp. If you see, you know, this is pretty much bomb proof because it tells you every step that you need to follow. So if I could do it, trust me, you could do it yourself too. Okay, let's say that Ironic is running. It is. Let's say that Ironic Inspector. And again, this is a little bit different from OpenStack because if you were using a full-fledged OpenStack, you will see much more components. This is not the case with Bifrost because basically we are trying to minimize the workload here. So it's, you know, basically kind of a thin version of Ironic. Okay, so we got now two, let's say, bare metal, fake bare metal machines being running. They are not running yet there, but the definitions are over there. And we got sushi tools running too. So we are going to be basically hooking up into the BMC. Activate this, export it off cloud. As we were speaking before, like basically this comes built in with two different drivers, which are IPMI and Redfish. If you want to add any additional drivers, you could pass any options to the Ansible playbook, and it would just get triggered, even those staging ones. I don't know, those staging ones comes like as a proof or are experimental or?
Which one?
The drivers on the staging, are they experimental or are they supported?
They're constantly experimental, yeah.
Okay, so maybe don't try those. So let's see what an inventory looks like. So it's pretty much what I was showing you before. You could even, you know, wanting to use host groups, you want to use specific properties, but in the end, you are basically setting like the machines, the configuration for the IPMI, passwords, SSH keys, and so. But you could just use a lot of specific configuration should you want to. So let's enroll these things out. I'm not using the dash dash white here, so should I be using those, that option? Bifrost would hold on and wait until the whole deployment is complete or failed, hopefully not, because they shouldn't, because we are super duper developers. But in any case, this is not the case here, so let's see what's going on. You see, now we got basically two different bare metal machines available to Ironic, so you could just basically go ahead and deploy an OS into those. As Dmitry was saying before, we are assuming some defaults to that, but you could use any image that you would like to use. You could just modify the defaults as well. It's like, you know, so, but we are just doing something simple here, so let's kick the deployment. Let's see what's going on. Okay, let's see. Oh, they are deploying already, blazing fast. at some point, this should just be going to, this is doing something. It's IPA is running there, so the Ironic Python agent is kicking off things there, and it's basically waiting to be calling the IPA again, so they enroll it there. But they're active. So, well, basically, that was the quick demo we wanted to show you here, guys here. But as Dmitry was saying, there's a lot of work to do here. So things you would like you could do to contribute here if you'd like to. Well, one of the things that I would really like to see here is, well, these playbooks were made before the Ansible execution environments were even designed. So it would be really cool to have one execution environment that you could just run, just dockerize, or using Podman or whatever you want to call it, just cryo-based, let's say, to run all these things. So if you are using Bifrost on your environment and you know got some things already done, or we're really looking for you to contribute it back. And again, so dependencies. Well, I hit the dependency issue with Python 3.6 here. That shouldn't be the case in Ansible execution environments because the Python version would be really hard-coded. In a former session from here, Dmitry and Yuri, which is, you know, basically the PTL of Ironic, so you can blame him about everything. We're discussing about Python packaging. Even though I love Python, I'm also a Go developer, and I have to say that I was totally lazy when I discovered that I could just go use Go mod vendor and forget about dependencies, weren't they using, copying the maximum version, minimum version, and so forth. That's somehow a pretty complex system that could be somehow avoided if you are just using one execution environment. So I think that would be really cool for newcomers because they wouldn't have to care about that at all. That said, I guess that was the demo, but questions so far? Could you go there, please?
Is there currently a way to have the nodes auto-discover by just pixie booting and then enrolling in Ironic without providing an inventory?
What did you say?
So the question was about auto-discovering nodes through pixie booting. Yes, there is such a way. It's a mode of Ironic Inspector which is enabled. I think there's an option to enable that. It's not on by default. You can enable it in Bifrost. It works. The usual problem is to know the BMC credentials. So Ironic will enroll the node for you. It will populate introspection data. But to manage it, you need to have these credentials. And some vendors actually have them well known. In this case, you can write a thing called introspection rules, which is a mini language inside of Ironic Inspector that defines the rules to execute on freshly introspected nodes. And you can say, if this is newly inspected and the vendor is Dell, set root Calvin, for example. if you don't have an easy solution for credentials problem, it may be harder. But yes, it is supported.
Thank you. The other thing then, because I come from the mass canonical world, where when you have the nodes just pixie boot, they get discovered, and then they do, as you say, they just run ipmi tool and set the username and password for the mass service. But you could do something similar, I suppose, with Ironic.
So the question is about just configuring credentials automatically, right? I think that's what Mellado is doing.
Yeah.
We had that, we dropped it. There's a lot of interesting issues around that, starting with the fact that it only works with APMI.
Okay.
So with Redfish, you cannot do that. It works sometimes, and also something we're trying to avoid in Ironic is to be primarily responsible for your BMC credentials. That's not the role we really wanted to take. We could probably integrate with Barbican, but yeah, we're not quite there. And there were also issues with that. So if it breaks midway, your hardware is in a weird state. So we made a conscious decision not to do that.
Thank you.
But you can write a plugin for Ironic Python agents to do it. If you're really curious, I can explain you how to do that later on.
Thank you.
Can I use something else but Libvirt, like OpenStack VMs? So for the servers, when you created the two VMs in Libvirt, can I use my OpenStack credentials somewhere?
I created the VMs with VRSH, and I'm using Sushi Tools, which is a tool to create a fake virtual VMC. But this is meant to be used by bare metal servers. If you can, I assume it should somehow work. I didn't test it, to be honest, creating VMs with Nova and attaching that to Sushi Tools. Mm-hmm. Give it a try.
I could have a specific turn-on for that and another one consuming.
Sushi Tools has an OpenStack backend. Mm-hmm. So Sushi Tools itself supports using Nova instead of Libvirt. Bifrost doesn't expose that. So with some hackery, you can do that.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Thanks.
But yeah, please keep in mind, that's only for testing. Bifrost is for bare metal.
So if I wanted to do, like, using OpenStack clouds for running my bare metal, I could just use Sushi directly. That's what you mean.
So Sushi Tools Sushi is a library. Sushi Tools is an emulator.
Okay.
Sushi Tools is what provides fake Redfish BMCs here, okay. But it's backed by Libvirt VMs. Okay. You can change the backend to be OpenStack. That will require some configuration, probably. Okay. Bifrost doesn't do by default.
Okay. Thanks.
Is there a way to upgrade the version of Ironic with Bifrost or not?
If you want
to upgrade to a major version of an existing deployment of Ironic using Bifrost, can you do it with the tool?
Yeah, pretty much every time, in the spirit of Ansible, every time you run install, it installs the latest version. So if you have an existing installation, for example, installed using Yoga, git pull Bifrost to that. You run install again. It will update everything to that.
Okay, that's perfect. Thank you.
We even do upgrade testing in the CI, and we even have some workarounds in our playbooks for upgrade issues. So, it's a supported case, yes.
Okay. Yeah, it's true. We didn't speak about that, but I think it's worth mentioning that it's all runs in CI.
Sorry. So, I think it's worth mentioning, and we didn't do that. That this is running on SUL on the CI, so every Ironic patch in the end is really running Bifrost over the CI, so I think it's pretty much bomb-proof.
No more questions?
Okay, then thanks all for attending, and enjoy the run.